All right, let's stand and sing that wonderful song on your pink sheet in your program called We Come Together. Woohoo! Take a look at the person next to you. Take a look. Say, I recognize the God in you.
Aha!
Now feel the love in the sanctuary. And lift your voice and repeat after me. Yeah, we come together. We come together. We come together. In the name of love, we come together. We come together. We come together in the name of love. All right, now. I think we need even a little more volume. Keep those clappers clapping. All right. Now take a look at the person next to you. Say, God loves you and I love you too. Now feel the love in the sanctuary. Oh, you feel that love. Lift your voice and repeat after me. We come together, we come together. We come together, we come together in the name of love. We come together, we come together. We come together in the name of love. Now every walk of life and every creed and color, in kinship we unite in honor of the God in each other. Take a look at the person next to you. This one is my favorite. Say, Namaste, I bow to you. And feel the love in the sanctuary. Lift your voice and repeat after me. We come together, we come together. We come together. We come together in the name of love. We come, come on. We come together. We come together in the name of love. We come together. In the name of love, we come together. We come together. We come together. Here we go. In the name of love.
Good. Can you hear me? Yes, you can. Good morning and happy Easter.
Good morning.
Y'all look so pretty. And the smiles on your faces, I love it. So, you're coming together on this day is extra special for me because it's just symbolic that no matter what kind of mess ups I do in my life, I can have a new beginning. And that's a wonderful thing to know. So, my name is Jackie Peterson.
Hi,
and, well, hi, Melinda. So on behalf of Reverend Donna and also the Board of Trustees, I am really privileged to welcome you here to the Sonoran Desert Center for Spiritual Living. Whoever you are, you're not only welcome, but you have to know that we support you. We love you. We honor the path that you're on, and we'll do everything to help you along the way. I love our vision statement. And I think because so many of you are regulars that I've seen here Sunday after Sunday, you all know it. So I want you to say it with me. And it is, love in action every day in every way. And we not only have that as our mission statement, but we believe it and we do it. And that's why we have such a family feeling here and have a lot of fun. So we express this love in action every day in every way by learning and living the principles of the science of mind. And those principles are printed on the back page of your bulletin. And if you would turn there now, and we'll read them together. I believe there is an infinite intelligence operating throughout the universe. I believe that power is only good. I believe this intelligence expresses as me. I believe through my conscious use of this power, I create my life as happy, healthy, and complete. And so it is. So if this is your first time here, we'd love to take a moment and have you introduce yourselves. Do we have some first-time people? I thought I didn't recognize you from across the room. Please stand up and tell us your name.
I'm Rick Canada.
Rick Canada? Where are you from, Rick?
From the Seattle area.
Well, welcome. Are you visiting or are you going to live here? Just visiting. Well, that's how it starts. Welcome, and please stay around afterwards and get to know some of us. Anyone else? Okay, Anna, nice to meet you too. See you again. So we have a tremendous number of volunteers. Everybody in this church seems like they volunteer at some point in time or another. Thank you. On behalf of Reverend Donna and the Board of Trustees, thank you, because we can't do it without volunteers. And in fact, that leads me into another ask. If you would look at your announcements that are inside of your bulletin, with that, please silence your phones. Dan, please silence your phone. So, and have a wonderful Easter Sunday.
You are visiting us for the first time. The words for our song to sing namaste to each other are inside your program on the left-hand page.
The God in me beholds the God in you. It is all for our greatest and highest good. The God in me beholds the God in you, and you and I are one. Namaste. The God in me beholds the God in you. It is all for our greatest and highest good. The God in me beholds the God in you, and you and I are one. Namaste. Namaste.
Good morning, I'm Melinda. Now that we have you all centered and calm, I want to introduce a friend I brought with me today. He's 20 years old.
Come on, all you bunnies, clap your hands. Come on, let's wiggle it in like we did last Easter.
Thank you. 20 years I've had that thing. I get it out only on Easter. So our invocation, let my words be your words. I'm happy and complete today and forever. Within me is that which is perfect and complete. It is the spirit of life, truth, and action. The spirit that pushed the irises' green leaves up through the dry ground. The spirit that births new baby bunnies. The spirit that brings forth huge, colorful blooms from a thorny cactus. The spirit that brings new awakenings to the unlimited possibilities of life. As perfection is already accomplished, and I know this service helps us to remember the truth of our magnificence, let us each be our magnificence. And together we say, so it is. And I'm going to light this candle, and as I do so, I'm going to insert the vibration of love and light that expresses the limitlessness of all good. And I will take it with me over to the prayer table as I hold the high watch and await your prayer requests. Today, my message is from Alan Cohen from a book called Joy is My Compass. I do not believe that Jesus sought to establish a religion separate or in competition with others. If Jesus walked today, I wonder how he would feel about the separations that have been created in his name. So many of us have used the name of Jesus and the Christian religion to justify actions that have little to do with the great healing principles Jesus came to glorify. Jesus is happy to work with Christian religion, without the Christian religion, or within any other religion. Spirit welcomes all opportunities to forgiveness. The religion of love is not confined to a rectangle of stone walls. The creed of sharing is where you are. To find that Christ in your own heart is to become all that Jesus was and is. The God who lived and lives within him is willing to work just as powerfully within you and me. Jesus said, "Even greater things than I do shall you do." This promise applies to everyone, no matter what religion through which we come to the light. The word Christ means the anointed one. If you find the light, you are anointed, and you are one with the Christ. Now today, we too must claim our perfection. The churches we attend externally are reflections, are representations of the inner church, where the flame of love burns eternally on the altar of the heart. It is a presence that we carry with us wherever we go, a sanctuary of inner comfort in which we may find refuge with the struggle of separation and when it has become more than we can bear. Jesus brought the world a demonstration of one to whom the peace of God was more important than anything the world had to offer. His interest was in healing. He had no dogma, only compassion. He prescribed no practices save forgiveness. He may aptly be called the Christ, the Savior, for that is what he saw and found in us. Namaste.
How about a big hand for our first choir in 2 years? Woo-hoo! All right, and guess what? We decided that you're all part of the choir today, too. You have just three little lines. Your first line is?
Light.
Your second line is?
Hope.
And your third line is?
Love.
Aha! So, when we point to you, that's your cue to shout out your three lines. So once again, they are?
Light, hope, and love.
Uh-huh, one more time out here. I want to hear the rest of my choir. Light, hope, and love. Yes, all right. We ready?
Yes.
Bring all the hurt you've caused and watch it wash away. Come to the riverside, drink from the well of life. Let there be light,
light,
shining in the shadows. Let there be hope,
hope,
when the eyes close. Let there be love,
love,
healing that is broken. Spirit is the light that leads us home. Come all you wandering souls who feel you try it all. Bring all your emptiness and know that are whole. Come to the mountainside where love will never die. Let there be light,
light,
shining in the shadows. Let there be hope,
hope,
holding us close. Let there be love,
love,
healing what is broken. Spirit, the light that leads us home. It's the love we all deserve. We love every day, every way. It's the love we all deserve. We love every day, every way. It's the love we all deserve. We love every day, every way. It's the love we all deserve. We love every day, every way. Come to the riverside, drink from the well of life. Come to the place of love and light. Let it be light,
light,
shining in the shadows. Let there be hope,
hope,
holding us close. Let there be love,
love,
healing what is broken. Spirit is the light that leads us home. Spirit is the light that leads us home. Spirit is the light that leads us home.
My goodness. Wow, thank you. Thank you all so very much. This is always in my nose. Yeah, it's true. Ernest Holmes had one. He did. He was a little short guy and he had a great big huge lectern,
and there was a box to stand on, and if you didn't know and you were up there, you fell off. Anyway, that has nothing to do with my talk, so good morning. Happy Easter. Now, today is special for me in several ways, because years ago when we had our center in Florida, John and I began a tradition that he would share the Sunday message for Easter and for the Sunday prior to Christmas. Because it's a way for me to show you how much John really supports me, and it also gives you a chance to know him at a different level. It's pretty wonderful to have a spiritual mate, you know, that you can talk to, and I have that in John. So today the Christian world celebrates Easter, and thoughts turn to Jesus. The extraordinary man, his life, his death, the resurrection, the promise of immortality. John and I chose as our topic No Greater Love, which comes from John chapter 15. These things I have spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you and that your joy might be full. This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. Greater love has no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. The last statement has been taken to mean that Jesus died for his friends and that he died for us as a redemption of our sins. But I challenge that interpretation, because from all scriptural accounts, Jesus knew he was going to die, and it appeared as little concern to him. What concerned him more was that his disciples, his friends, the ones that had walked with him that for that very short time, had understood his life as his message and would be able to continue to teach it to the world. This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you. And I believe this was the life Jesus was talking about, not dying for someone else as an ultimate sacrifice, but living fully and loving totally within this parenthesis in time we call birth to death. And it's this message that over 2,000 years later we follow, we teach, we do our best to embody. There is no greater love than a life lived fully and a heart shared completely. These things I have spoken to you, that my joy might remain in you and that your joy might be full. Bishop John Shelby Spong, in his book, A New Christianity for a New World, says, we observe that there is something expansive and creative about the presence of the boundary-breaking love that we meet in the life of Jesus. When we human beings know love, we seem to grow. Love is present in embryonic forms in all aspects of life. It is seen when the subhuman species of life guard the hiding places of their young. When the tongue of an adult feline creature washes the fur of her kitten. When the bird flies forth to gather food for the helpless occupants of the nest. When two turtle doves couple in a lifelong union. But this life-giving love is even more profoundly seen in the human experience, where it can be entered self-consciously, chosen freely, and appropriated fully. So Jesus presented us with this life-giving love because he did enter into it self-consciously. He chose it freely, and he appropriated it. You know, it is the Father within me that does the work. And he invited us to do the same thing. Let my joy remain in you, that your joy may be full. So to enter into life-giving love self-consciously, we first need to realize the truth of who we are. We are a divine idea in the mind of God. We are spirit in form and in expression. We are God being God as us. And I know that we hear these things constantly, but these words
But these are words that need to be chewed and swallowed, you know, so that we completely embody them and we have complete confidence in their truth. Jesus said, I and the Father are one. And he was saying, I am God being God as Jesus. And I can say, I am God being God as Donna. And you can say, I am God being God as you. You know, enter name here. Our founder, Dr. Ernest Holmes, says, when we become conscious of our existence as an idea in the mind of God, we shall find that we are walking in pathways of peace, that something within us acts like a magnet to attract that which belongs to itself. This something is love, the supreme impulsion of the universe. So no one can express love to its fullest if they believe that they're alone in the world, if they're not rooted in the assurance there is something more of which they are a part. To express love freely, completely, and totally, our self-assurance must be grounded in the assurance of a power greater than we are, that is not only all there is, but that we're it. I of myself can do nothing. It's the Father within me that does the work. When we realize the truth of who we are, then we can freely choose to love, because love is not only a power, but it's a choice. And we are at choice point every minute of the day. With any encounter, we ask ourselves, how do I choose love in this experience? Where can I put my littleness aside and step into the bigness of love? And choosing love is not always easy. Certainly the world would be in our corner if we chose to retaliate to an unkind word or deed. People would support us if we held a grudge against someone who caused us harm. But we are the ones who are harmed when we hold on to anger, resentment, or fear. And choosing love is the only way that we are healed. And when we are healed, the situation automatically heals. I read a story one time of a woman who took her little kids for dinner. She asked her young son to say grace. He said, thank you, God, for this food, and I hope you let us have ice cream for dessert. Amen. Well, a woman within earshot heard the little boy and said loud enough for the family to hear, imagine praying for ice cream. Someone needs to teach this boy to pray properly. The little boy burst into tears. Did I do it wrong, Mama? The mother held her child, assured him he had done a terrific job, and certainly God was not mad at him. And about that time, an elderly gentleman approached the table. He winked at the boy and said, I happen to know that God thought that was a really great prayer. Really, the child asked, cross my heart. Then, in a theatrical whisper, he added, indicating the woman whose remark had started the whole thing, too bad she never asked God for ice cream. A little ice cream is good for the soul sometimes. Naturally, Mom bought ice cream at the end of the meal. The little boy stared at his for a moment, and then he picked up his sundae and without a word walked over and placed it in front of the woman. And with a big smile, he told her, here, this is for you. Ice cream is good for the soul sometimes, and my soul is good already. So like the woman, many of us have grown up believing that it's selfish to claim the good of life. You know, we might have grown up with the idea that if I'm praying for something petty, I'm taking God away from something important, you know? But we have to appropriate God. God is everywhere. There's no place where God cannot be of service, you know? Spirit is infinite in its ability for expression. And it's kind of like if I use the number 4 when I am balancing my checkbook, I'm not taking your 4 away when you balance yours. You know, spirit is like that. There are infinite number of 4s. There's an infinite amount of the power and presence of God. It doesn't stop. It doesn't have a limit. It doesn't say, I'm working on world peace. Forget what you're praying about, you know? Okay. Love is a choice that is good for the soul. So when our love is called forth through choice, through forgiveness, through looking beyond appearances, through compassion that feels the pain in another person, then we become the agent, the change agent for good. And there is no greater love than that which is good for the soul. Thank you. Namaste. And here's John.
Hey, John.
Good morning. No greater love have I for my God. No greater love have I than the love of my family. No greater love have I than for my spiritual home and family. And no greater love than I have for myself. Believing in God, we must believe in ourselves because we are expressions of God. Loving God, we must love others because each person is a manifestation of God. That was a message of Jesus, that ye love one another as I have loved you. There are many components within the power of love. There is the power of forgiveness, the power to forgive others, and what we believe was hurtful and intentional is to be able to use love to move beyond any hurt and repair any wounds. It has been said before that love never judges. Love simply announces that neither the person you are nor the deeds you have done have erected a barrier which the power of this invincible presence cannot overcome. As we drop our judgments, our resentments, and lead with love, we can forgive others and at the same time forgive ourselves. Civil rights leader Martin Luther King has said, "Love is the only force capable of transforming an enemy into a friend. He who is devoid of the power to forgive is devoid of the power of love." Another component of love is the power of choice. Our founder, Ernest Holmes, says we cannot live a choiceless life. Every day, every moment, every second, there is a choice. If we're not so, we would not be individuals. We don't have to choose love, but are there really any positive benefits in not choosing love? Ernest Holmes says the power of choice with which we have been endowed is either our greatest blessing or our greatest curse. Properly understood, it can lift us to the heights. Misunderstood, it can drag us into the depths. We are free to choose anything we wish, but we must accept the responsibility for our choices, because the law will create our experiences according to our choices. Gratitude is still another component of love. Often I've heard during a religious service giving glory to God as a means of giving thanks for God, for all that God has given. I like what Henry David Thoreau said one time, "I am grateful for what I am and have. My thanksgiving is perpetual. I am perpetually," this is unquote Thoreau, "I am perpetually thankful that God has given us the power to forgive our enemies and our friends and ourselves. I am perpetually thankful that God has given us the power of choice to choose the good in our lives. I am perpetually thankful that we are God in expression so that we can do the work necessary to change the world." The power of love is also the power of God. There is no greater love than God has for us. This is the power that created the universe. It created the life that lives through you and me. Gandhi said, "Where there is love, there is life. And the day the power of love overrules the love of power, the world will know peace." In the celebration of Easter, many will commemorate the death and resurrection of Jesus as an assurance that Jesus' life was given for our sins. What are we to believe as we celebrate Easter in our center for special living? I would say believe in yourself as Jesus believed in himself. Believe in a loving God as Jesus taught. Believe in the words of Jesus that you can do even greater things than he did. I'd like to close with the beautiful words by a beautiful person, Bishop John Shelby Spong. A life defined by love will not seek to protect itself or justify itself. It will be content simply to be itself and to give itself away with abandon. If denied, love embraces the denier. If betrayed, love embraces the betrayer. If forsaken, love embraces the forsaker. If crucified, love embraces the killers. It has been my pleasure to speak to you today and wish you all a happy Easter. And I know that I love you all, and I may we all continue to spread our love to everything and everyone, and namaste.
Who's ready to stand and sing?
Apparently everyone. It's like, all right, let's go.
In the name of love, with a heart of grace, overflowing us, decorate this place. As it is below, so it is above. May we always stand in the name of love. When the veil is gone, there's only one of us, only one, in the name of love. In the name of love, in the name of love, may we always be seeking out the best till we all are free. Living in a world we've been dreaming of, where we stand as one in the name of love.
Time for our offering. That's a chance to put the law of divine circulation in order. So I ask that you join me in our offering affirmation on the left-hand side of our bulletin. My gift goes forth to heal, prosper, and bless all that it touches. It is evidence of my conviction that God is the source and substance of my supply. I share generously of my good, knowing that it returns to me, multiplied abundantly, and so it is. Thank you. I'm so glad you got that song in. It's an Easter song, you know, that we didn't know where to put it, so I'm very happy that Heather found a space for it, because it is one of my favorites. So I want to thank you for your generosity that helps us you know, survive in this community, and helps us thrive, and helps us help other people. And so there's a lot of things we do behind the scenes, and it's really kind of neat that you're all a part of it, and you may not even know it. So, okay, so let's close this portion out in prayer, and looks like there's quite a few. Yeah, Susan is saying, come, there's lots of stuff to eat. So let's just take a moment to give thanks, to recognize that no matter where our belief system lies, that this man we call Jesus had something so powerful that it crossed cultural barriers, it crossed language, it crossed eons. And today, we honor that man and that teaching that brings alive the love in our life. I speak my word for anyone who's having a personal challenge. And I speak my word for the Ukraine and other places that are experiencing war that sometimes we don't even hear about. And know that right where those places of chaos are, the power of love is also there, working behind the scenes to bring about a healing. I speak my word for each one of us as we go about our day and our week to recognize that we are the power of love in action. And as such, we are change agents for the world. I give thanks to be part of the spiritual family and to know that indeed we are good and very good as we say together, and so it is. happy. May we stand and sing Stand.
So let there be peace, I am a stand for peace. Let there be love, I am a stand for love. Let there be joy,